In this video, we'll talk about getting user input. Most of the examples we've done so far are printing stuff out, which is okay, but it's not really real life, right? We normally will be getting some sort of input from the users to make our program do something that the user wants to accomplish. And so I'll go ahead and create a new Java program, public class input fun. Public static void main string args. And to get input, we're going to need a little bit of help. The way that Java is built, it doesn't include everything you can do in the beginning. There's other programs that include everything basically that you can do from the beginning, and those files end up being very big. Well, one of the things about Java that we see is it's used a lot on the internet. And on the internet, where everything we do on the internet is requiring that something be downloaded or uploaded, and there's interaction going across wires and wireless signals, and that we want to keep things as small as possible. And so Java is kind of slick in that way, in that it only includes what it needs to include. It's got the basics built into it, which makes for very small programs, and then if we need other functionality, we can bring that in. The way that we bring that in is to import. And so before our class declaration, we are going to import a file. Now in this case, the file we need is the scanner file, and the scanner file is found in the Java util library. And so the way that we import this is to say import java.util.scanner, and that will bring in the scanner file that we need to be able to get input from the user. Okay, so that is going out to the library and accessing the file, or maybe a better way of saying it is it's referencing that library now as part of your program, which means you can now use a scanner in your program. And so the declaration to get input goes like this. Scanner with a capital S, that's the name of the class that we're going to be using to get the input, and then we got to give it a name. And so because it's coming in from the user, I'll just call it in. So scanner in equals new scanner, and then where are we going to get our input from? From the system.in. Okay, so scanner in equals new scanner system in. This part, just like a variable, is the declaration. We're declaring that we want to build a new scanner object, and we want to call it in. We're going to set that equal to a new scanner, and that scanner is going to be attached to the system in. So it's going to be reading from down here, in essence. Whatever we type down in here is what it's going to be reading in. We can attach scanners to different things. We'll do it later on with files. We'll attach a scanner to a file and then read in from the file. Okay, so now we've got the tool. So by importing this file and then setting it up, we are now prepared to read in information. The problem is, what are we going to read it into? We need something to read it into. And so I'll create a string variable, so a string type, and I'll call it name, and then we want to initialize that in doing good practice. So we're going to set it equal to blank, so there's not a null in there. And now we have a variable to hold whatever it is we're going to read in. And so the way we read in is this. First of all, we need to talk to the user. And the way we do that for now is just to print a line out at what we call the console, where they're in working. And so I'm just going to say system.out.println and say, please enter your name. The very first program I wrote years and years and years ago, I can't even remember what it was that we were using at the time. I was just a little kid, was asking the name. They'd type in their name, and then it would say hello, and then the name. So that's what we'll write here. So we're going to ask the user to please enter your name, and then we're going to get the input by saying, I want to put into this name variable that I've created, I want to set it equal to, just like we set it a variable equal to a number or something, I want to set this equal to my in dot next line is what we say. Okay, so go out using the scanner that we're going to refer to as in and get the next line of text that's out there and then store that in the name variable. Okay? You following along okay? So I'll save this and then compile it. And if I run it, it says please enter your name, and then it waits because it's waiting for me to input something. So I'll type my name, Spencer. And it doesn't do anything after that. Well, that's because I haven't told it to do anything after that. So I'm going to come in after that and then print out. And we learned about concatenation already. So I'm going to say system.out.println. And I'm going to say hello, comma, and then concatenate on the name that I've just stored. Making sense? So let's try running this. So please enter your name, Spencer, and it's going to say, hello, Spencer. Okay. And I probably ought to put some, I'm looking at my code and I'm not liking it. And the reason I'm not liking it is because I'm starting to get just a bunch of lines without any comments. So I'm going to say a little comment here that says something like, get username to print greeting. So just a little line to tell me what's going on in the next few lines of code. And then maybe here I could say print greeting. Kind of just little notes to explain what's going on in the program, but that's the general idea here. We're going to get the information. So we've set up our scanner by doing the import and creating the scanner. We've set up a variable to store the information that's going to be input. And then we can print out to the user, asking them to enter their name. We read that in by setting the name variable equal to whatever is coming out of that scanner object. Using this next line, and then once we've stored that, then we can print out and say hello and then the name. All right, so the question is, what happens if instead of let's say I was trying to read in a number instead of a name? Okay, so that's to read in a name. Let's say I create another variable called double, let's read in what's something good, like you never ask a person how much they weigh, right? So let's ask them their weight. Okay, so weight. We're going to get their weight. Please. This is how I always greet people. Please, what's your name? And then how much do you weigh? This is my normal greeting. So I'm going to set the weight equal to 0 initially. And then after I print out hello and then the name, so I've declared a variable for weight, I am going to get that, check the weight. I only associate people socially that are in my same weight class. In wrestling, they have weight classes and boxing and whatnot. That's how I run my social life. They have to be in my weight class. Okay, so so let's ask them for their weight. So system.out.println, and we'll say, how much do you weigh? Okay, so let's read that in. So the name of the variable that I created to store that information was called weight. And so I'll say weight is equal to in dot, and I'm just for now, I'm going to do next line. So we can generate a little error here. The error says, very unprofessional. I've got a cell phone going off. Sorry about that. But we're 10 minutes and 5 seconds in. I'm not going back. I'm not redoing this. Okay. So we've got a weight that we're storing. And when we try and run this, it's telling us incompatible types. The next line is designed to read in text. Okay. And so it's coming in as words, and I'm trying to store words in the weight variable, which doesn't work. Well, the good news is the scanner class that I've called in, and again, this is just the name I'm giving it, just like a variable name. I'm saying I don't want to change the actual scanner class itself. I want to create an instance of the scanner class that I'm going to call in, and it gives me the option, instead of doing a next line, I can say next double. Okay. Now it runs fine. And so we could print out that information, system.out.println. We could say weight, and then print out their weight that they just entered to make sure that this works okay. Okay, so please enter your name, Spencer. How much do you weigh? Totally inappropriate. Let's say 200 pounds. Okay, so weight is 200. So we got that information okay. Well, let's create another variable. What else could we ask them that's inappropriate? Let's ask them how old they are. Okay, so int age. And I'll set that equal to begin with, or set that equal to 0 to begin with. And so that's initializing that variable, right? So then I can ask them system.out.println, how old are you? Okay, and then same thing, we can set the age equal to in, except for now we're getting an int instead of a double. And guess what? If we get, just like we had a next double and a next line, we can read in the integer by saying next int. Okay. And then we can print that out to make sure that it worked. I'm slacking on my commenting here. So the age, and then print that out. And then whatever the age is. Okay, so let's try this. So please enter your name, Spencer. How much do you weigh? Okay, 250. How old are you? I'm 45, let's say. Okay, so then it prints out the age of 45. And so we've got all this information. It's being stored. We've read it in input. It's being stored. And then we can take that input and use it to print out information. And everything starts to come together, because now we can take that information and concatenate it together and have it all work together for our system. We could do math with it. And so we're starting to get to the point where we can do more things in Java because we can read in input. So the other one that we haven't talked about, instead of using a next line here, I could just use a next. And the next will read in the next word to the next space. So if I typed in two names and I did a next, it would only read in one of the names to the space, if that makes sense. So those are the different options we have available to us. A next, which reads in one word. A next line, which will read in the whole line. Next double to read in a double. And then a next int to read in an integer. And that should satisfy our needs for getting input. All right? Easy enough. Okay, Spencer out.